many colors. We're fighting for our lives. We are a rainbow, burning bold and bright. True and proud of the colors in our lives. Sing it with me one time. We are a rainbow, burning bold and bright. A people of many colors, we're fighting for our lives. We are a rainbow, burning bold and bright. True and proud of the colors in our lives. No matter what names you call me when you walk by, no matter how much of my life you choose to deny, I will not go away, I will not hide. I'm staying true to my colors deep inside. We are a rainbow, burning bold and bright. A people of many colors, we're fighting for our lives. We are a rainbow, burning bold and bright. True and proud of the colors in our lives. No matter how silent you want me to be, the more of my rights you take, the clearer it is to me. The less you validate, the bolder I become. After a drought, there is always a rainstorm. We are a rainbow, burning bold and bright. A people of many colors, we're fighting for our lives. We are a rainbow, burning bold and bright.
We gather tonight with others across this county, this region, our state, and across the country. We gather heartbroken and heartsick by the tragic loss of life in the early hours of Sunday at a safe haven for the LGBTQ community in Orlando, Florida. We gather to mourn, to share our grief, to cry, to pray, to sing, and to be together. At times like these, words fail me, and I turn to the wisdom of others that can give me solace and comfort. And so we begin with these words from the poet Jack O'Donohue. Now that we have entered with an open heart into a complex and fragile situation, hoping with patience and respect to tread softly over sore ground, in order that somewhere beneath the raw estrangement, some fresh spring of healing might be coaxed, to release the grace for a new journey beyond repetition and judgment, and have achieved nothing of that but emerged helpless and with added hurt,
May we withdraw for a while into our own tranquility, loosen from our heart this new fetter, free ourselves of the wounded gaze that is not yet able to see each other. Recognize our responsibility for the past, but not allow our sense of self to wilt. May we draw deep from our own dignity, temper our expectations of the other's limits, and take our time carefully, learning that there is a time for everything, hurting first, then for healing too, but that time may not be quite yet.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for coming out. My name is Rich Madalino, as probably, hopefully, some of you know in this room. I want to thank you all so much for coming out and sharing this evening and spending some time remembering the 49 victims and thinking about how we move forward. It's especially important to me for this to occur here. I've been part of several of these events, but it has such special significance for it to be here because I've always considered this, like many of you, a safe space to be who I was, who I am. It's very funny that, and a good coincidence that Lynn Peters is here. Because the very first time, maybe some of you know the story, the very first time I walked into Cedar Lane, just by chance, happened to be the Holiday Craft Show, the Holiday Craft Day in 1995. And two things happened. I saw a sign at the front door that said, "We are a welcoming congregation." As someone who grew up Catholic, went to an all-boys Catholic school not far from here, I'd never seen that in a religious community. And then the other thing was Lynn Peters said hello to me. It's very fortuitous that she happened to be walking by and asked me who I was and made me sign up for the newsletter. My life has never been the same. As I often tell people, when I first came to my first service and the doors were open for all of the name tags, I was shocked to see all the pink triangles and the rainbow flags and all the name tags. I mean, truly, having spent my whole life in Montgomery County, I had never thought that there were so many gay people in Montgomery County. And then when I came to my first coffee and I saw all these people wearing their name tags, I never knew there were so many older lesbians in Montgomery County. So I was amazed to discover that almost all of them were, in fact, not lesbians. But they were people who were making a conscious effort at a time, 20 years ago, when that meant even more to say, "You're welcome to talk to me. I embrace you and I want you here." I didn't realize what an effort a welcoming congregation was, the process to go through, and it was amazing to see that a religious congregation voted to welcome gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender individuals into their midst. So this gave me space to grow and be who I wanted to be. For that and for all of you, I am eternally grateful. Saturday, or this past weekend, as probably maybe many of you know, was the Capitol Pride festivities downtown. Saturday was the parade, and this year we marched with Rainbow Families. We marched with Tony Bennetti, Audrey was not there, but Tony and his husband Matt and Mark and I and Jackson and Katie marched with a whole other group of gay and lesbian families under the banner of Rainbow Families and the Human Rights Campaign. It was a beautiful day on Saturday. Maybe a little hot when you're on the black asphalt, but other than that, it was a beautiful, clear day. Lots of people And there were several times Mark and I talked about how amazing the change was and has been in this country over the last 20, 30 years. And as an aside, I don't think any of those things would not have happened without the Unitarian Universalist movement being at the very forefront of pushing for equality, of pushing for recognition of marriage equality. So it was just it was a fun, wonderful day. Even if I got a little diva-ish at the end, because after 4 miles of walking, it was I kind of tailed behind everyone and was holding up the whole parade. So this is what happens when you're now almost 51, right? So so we went home that day just filled with excitement. And then to wake up the next morning to this news that just got worse every update, that there had been a shooting and that there were deaths. And I mean, it just got worse as the day went on. And I was just numb listening to it. I mean, maybe it's the sad part of being an American of the 21st century that, as Marco Rubio commented, oh, it was just Orlando's turn this time around, that we have mass shootings, and that we've almost come to understand that that just happens. But I was numb to what was going on, and then the phone started ringing in the afternoon, and it was local Muslim activists reaching out, wanting to know, who do we talk to in the gay community? What can we do together? We're both targets of this. How do we move forward together? And interestingly, that's when, for me, the tears started, because suddenly there was a sense of incredible sadness and hope of, wow, there were people that wanted to react and wanted to react right away. And that has been incredibly meaningful. You know, it struck me as this situation has unfolded over the last several days, and the news about the killer becomes more confusing and complex all the time. But one thing that struck me is many people were very quick to label the shooter, and they have been working really hard not to label the victims, not to talk about this being a target, a hate crime against the LGBT community. I mean, I guess if you work very hard to make sure that there isn't a, you don't believe in the concept of a hate crime, it's very hard to label something that clearly is a hate crime, a hate crime. So that's why it's been so incredibly important. Abby and I were at a wonderful event last night where the Muslim community came together with the LGBT community, with other religious communities, with other organizations in our county, and had a prayer service, a vigil, an iftar, a breaking of the fast for Ramadan all together. And it was amazing, because much like this congregation, I think, is a beacon in our community, our community is a beacon within our nation. Montgomery County is a special place where all sorts of people come together and want to be part of the community here. And when you think about building a future of love, of acceptance, if it can't happen here together, it's hard to believe it can happen anywhere. So thank you to all of you for being here. Thank you for all of you of always building a welcoming congregation, building a welcoming community, and wanting to be part of that continuing effort to build a loving community. Because right now, we are a gentle, angry people, but we are also a gentle, loving people. And we are gay and straight together. That song was really, who picked out that song? It's wonderful that it's in our hymnal, but it's true. Because right now, we are angry, and we are loving, and we're going to put that together to make changes, not just statutory changes, which I hope to be a part of, obviously, but to make other changes to make sure that this sort of act, as the president said, act of terror and act of hate cannot happen here, should not happen, and will not happen again in our country. And thank you for taking a moment to recognize a lot of people, 49 innocent people who were gunned down in their safe space. And if we read the names, we're going to read the names. If you haven't seen the names of the victims, you're going to hear something, a common thread that moves through them, and that is they're overwhelmingly Latino, because it was a Latino dance night that was occurring. So you have, I think it's important to note, a minority within a minority, and talk about, I can't imagine the sense of violation and isolation right now within the Latino LGBT community, as truly one of their safe spaces was so violated. And I think we have to remember to think about them and to think about all of the different people that we can continue to reach out to make sure that they find safe spaces in their own communities, and maybe one day make our entire community, if not our entire country, a safe space. So thank you all again very much for coming and for always being there for me, for always being there for our community.
As you feel moved, I invite you to come forward and light a candle. I ask that you please accept our apologies for any mispronounced names.
Stanley Amutova III, 23 years old, and their family.
Amanda Alvear, 25 years old.
Oscar A. Acarenda Montero, 26 years old.
Rodolfo Ayala, 33 years old.
Antonio Davon Brown, 29 years old.
Daryl Roman Burt II, 29 years old.
Angel L. Caradero Padro, 28 years old.
Juan Chavez Martinez, 25 years old.
Luis Daniel Conde, 39 years old.
Corey James Connell, 21 years old.
Tevin Eugene Crosby, 25 years old.
Bianca Deidra Drayton, 32 years old.
Simone Adrian Carrillo Fernandez, 31 years old.
Leroy Valentin Fernandez, 25 years old.
Mercedes Marisol Flores, 26 years old.
Peter Gonzalez Cruz, 22 years old.
Juan Ramon Guerrero, 22 years old.
Terrell Henry, 41 years old.
Frank Hernandez, 27 years old.
Miguel Angel Honorato, 30 years old.
Javier Jorge Reyes, 40 years old.
Jason Benjamin Yosefat, 19 years old.
Eddie Jamoroldro Justice, 30 years old.
Anthony Luis Loriano Disla, 25 years old.
Christopher Andrew Linonen, 32 years old.
Alejandro Barrios Martinez, 21 years old.
Brenda Lee Marquez McCool, 49 years old.
Gilberto Ramon Silva Menendez, 25 years old.
Kimberly Morris, 37 years old.
Akira Monet Murray, 18 years old.
Luis Omar Casio Campo, 20 years old.
Geraldo Ortiz Jimenez, 25 years old.
Eric Ivan Ortiz Riviera, 36 years old.
Joel Rayon Paniagua, 32 years old.
Jean Carlos Mendez Perez, 35 years old.
Enrique Rios Jr., 25 years old.
Sean C. Neves Rodriguez, 27 years old.
Javier Emmanuel Serrano Rosado, 35 years old.
Christopher Joseph Sanfelice, 24 years old.
Yomari Rodriguez Sullivan, 24 years old.
Edward Sotomayor Jr., 34 years old.
Shane Evan Tomlinson, 33 years old.
Martin Benitez Torres, 33 years old.
Jonathan Antonio Camuy Vega, 24 years old.
Juan P. Rivera Velasquez, 37 years old.
Luis Vielma, 22 years old.
Frankie Jimmy De Jesus Velasquez, 50 years old.
Luis Danielle Wilson Leon, 37 years old.
Gerald Arthur Wright. We remember them.
My name is Jim Stowe. I serve as your executive director for the Montgomery County Office of Human Rights. And I am here on behalf of our community, those who make up this marvelous place that we call Montgomery County, over 1 million people, better than 500 square miles, over 264 different languages spoken in our public schools. Great community. As I listened to the names this evening and heard them also last night with Anderson Cooper, and while geography will not put us in the place and time of what took place early Saturday morning and Sunday morning, it struck me that I knew those 49 persons. I knew those 53. Because you see, they were and could have been my son. They were and could have been my daughter. They were and could have been my coworker. They were and could have been my neighbor. They were somebody's child. You know, the great debate now is about gun control, what we should do and what we should not do. But my friends, if the killing of 26 children and Sandy Hook could not move us to do something that's reasonable and just makes common sense, I'm not so sure, as heinous as this was, whether or not we're moved to do something now. But what I remember is this. In the words of Dr. King, and I'm paraphrasing, I can never be what I ought to be until you are what you ought to be. That we are tied together with a single cord of mutuality. What affects you directly affects me indirectly. And so, in fact, if I cannot be all that I am intended to be, because 49 people will never be what they were intended to be, I lost something. Every time a young person is killed in this community, we all lost something. In the streets, highways, and byways of this great country, every time there's a mass shooting, and by the way, they happen almost every weekend in some cities across America, we lose something. And so I've come tonight to share that on the other side is also born every day a brand new life that gives us another opportunity to be better than we were the day before. And so I would just share this one thought with you today as I close. It's entitled, Our Cause. The cause we believe in is our pilot. If we are true to it, we will not drift. Committed, we can steer across the troubled waters. Determined, our path can be navigated through deep channels. Our deeds and actions, not our words, shall be our log and evidence of our journey. Faith and dedication shall guide us in our purpose if our cause is right. Yea, though we sail amidst the thunder of injustice and the tempest of prejudice, we will dread no longer. For our resolve is quickened and our strength renewed by our belief that justice will prevail. Our love and concern and sense of fair play will shelter us. We will find a harbor of support and unity by those who believe that there is a better way. Our ideals will anoint the waves with oil. Our ship of goodwill and hope will ride calmly. And surely, surely, the sunlight of a new day and the starlight of new possibilities shall favor us on the voyage we take. And we shall anchor in the port of the world where differences are celebrated, every life held precious, and where the dignity and the respect for all humanity reigns supreme.
Let your love shine through today and start this by loving yourself. Start with believing, with knowing that it's only by loving ourselves that others love us in return, and that when others love us in return, the world shifts on its axis. We will not forget Pulse. We must not forget Pulse, as we have not forgotten Stonewall. In the years to come, it will motivate us to transform violence into peace, hatred into love. And someday, we will find ourselves in the place we have created through our love and courage, that place over the rainbow. Go in peace. Go making peace. Live gently, love mightily, and bow.